Hello everyone, it's me Fatima Hunda Bedi. Now this is the third part of our public speaking series. Again, when you're super anxious, when you're on stage, you tend to have this feeling inside your stomach as if there's a lot of butterflies inside your stomach. So we call it the butterfly problem. You know, we say we're having a lot of butterflies. In English, that's the usage that we usually use when you're like really anxious, when you have this feeling inside your stomach. Now, how can you eliminate this feeling? Because this can like totally ruin how you're presenting on stage or for that matter anywhere else as well. Now the first thing that I want you to do before entering a stage is that you have to think about the keywords or exactly what you want to look like when you're presenting on stage. So say if I'm coming over here, what is my aim? What is my goal? How do I want you guys to think about me and my content and my video today? Now I can think about myself and I can be like, you know, this, I can think to myself what I actually want. Say if I want to be engaging, I want to look like I'm a fun person, I want the content to be really interesting, I want me to look like a knowledgeable person. So whatever your goals are, you can like, you know, you can rethink about that. You can remind yourself, this is what you're aiming for. You're aiming forward to look confident, engaging, fun, knowledgeable, whatever that is, that whatever matters to you, you can keep reminding yourself what you're aiming for, because this will give you a direction in order to do whatever you're doing. So it'll give you a direction on how you're supposed to be acting, and it'll make really your job very easy when you're up on stage. It'll also reduce anxiety, thus reducing butterflies. Now the next tip is something that you might not really agree upon, but this is something that always works for me. That is to intend to ruin the show. Now what happens is that if you look at it, the more you try to forget something, the more you remember that, right? It's almost the same logic. Whenever you try to deliberately ruin a show, it turns out to be not so ruined. And that's something, at least that's something that happens to me most of the time. Because I'll give you a small example. So I used to have this piano class that I used to join as an extracurricular activity back in school. And I wasn't interested in doing that. Like I really didn't want to join that class. But then I had to, because there's nothing else that was interesting as well. And then I joined this. So as I didn't really care much about the course, I was like, yeah, let's just go with the flow. Even if I screw up, there's no problem. So this is my, this used to be my mindset. So whenever the sir used to ask me to play the piano, like I'll be like, you know, it's okay to screw up. It's okay if I make a mistake. It's okay, like, you know, if it goes wrong. And I was intending to do it just so that I could come out of the class. And then every single time I tried to do that, I realized that I was doing a pretty good job because I didn't have anything to fear about. I wasn't afraid about losing anything, and I didn't really pay attention to how perfectly I'm doing things. Now, when this happened, I realized this is a good strategy to go by even when I want to do something very well. So I always try myself. It's okay to it's okay to ruin the show, because I'll always find a reason of why I don't want to do it. So if I'm doing a public speaking event, or say if I'm doing the shoot itself for that matter, I'll be like, it's okay to screw up. Even if I do make a mistake, it's fine, because, you know, I don't want to be a public figure anyway. Like, I didn't want to do this. I didn't want to be like this. So I'll tell myself that. And that gives me a lot of confidence. Now, like, you know, it's not even a matter, even if I end up making a mistake. So this is one thing that has helped me out, and I really hope it helps you out as well. When you try to find out reasons why you don't want to do it, and when you keep that in mind and you're like, you know, it's fine. If it's not plan A, at least plan B is there if you end up ruining it. Now, the last tip is to prepare for the worst case scenario. Now, there are so many mistakes that we can make, especially when it's a live show, when you're, you know, going on stage and all that. It's not something like a shoot, right? So there is a lot of chance that there might be some technical problems, or you might have some tongue slips, you might forget things in between, you might have a mind block. So these are all possibilities that you have to address. So when you're preparing a speech, when you're like trying to think of the best possible scenario, you're like, you know, you're gonna do a good job, you're gonna nail it down. If you think of the whole situation that way, you won't be prepared for something that might be coming ahead of you. So what you can do is always prepare for the worst case scenarios. Always prepare how exactly you're gonna deal with the problem in case if you have a tongue slip, or in case if you forget something, what are you gonna say to the public? How are we gonna make it sound really fun and not so serious, and how are we gonna deal with the whole situation? Always make sure you're prepared for that. In case if you trip on the floor, trip on the stage, what are you gonna say? How are you gonna deal with the situation? Always be prepared for all of that, and make sure that you have a good action, good reaction, and good answer to all the problems that might occur on the way. Now that's it for this video. I really hope this series and this video was helpful for you all. In case if you want to know more about the courses that we provide at English House, you can go ahead and click on the link below. Thank you so much for watching.
English House. English at your fingertips.